The guitar is an interesting instrument. You can play it a lot of different ways. Like you hear it in churches today, a lot of praise and worship where they strum a lot. They'll do that for days. And then you have picking stuff where like a lot of bluegrass people, you get on one string. It's kind of considered, to me, like a stuttering style. You get on one string and go back and forth. That's all you have to do. Just, you know, you either pick it or if you are a little nervous, it doesn't matter. You, that's all you do. Just, so anyway, it's kind of a picking style. Then there's a third style. It's one of my favorite styles of all. Back when you didn't have people that played like you'd have one guitar in a group. And so the guy would have to be the bass guitar picker, and he would. And then he'd pick the melodies and counter melodies around it. They say it's hard to do, that to do like two things at one time, but the doctor told me that the left side of my brain wasn't right. And the right side of my brain didn't have much left. In fact, the way I'm wired, I'm really considering when I die, just giving my body to science fiction. So anyway, you don't hear that style a whole lot. And I was up doing a concert with Mr. Ricky Skaggs up in Western Canada. And I was up there, and out in the middle of nowhere, those wheat fields and stuff out in the middle where the buffalo play and all that, there's nothing around there. There was a 19-year-old boy over by the edge of the stage, and I heard him over there, and he was just going. I heard him over there going. And I walked over there, and my socks went up and down three times. I said, son, where did you learn to pick like that? He said, well, I listened to a lot of records. He said, you're a Southerner, aren't you? Didn't even know I was. I said, yeah, born in the South and proud of it. He said, do you Southerners know the song I'll Fly Away? I said, I'll have thou knowest, O youngest boy, sitting on the edge of thy stage. When I get nervous or a little upset, I start talking in King James. I said, I'll have thou knowest, O young boy, that it was a Southerner who wrote I'll Fly Away. And not only that, Albert E. Brumley, but we down South can sing that song. Not only frontwards, we can sing it backwards. We know it. So we got together and picked a little guitar and had a good time. Now, page two. I'm coming home on the plane. It's about 36,000 feet. At least that's what the pilot told me. And I didn't measure it myself. And we're going along there, and it's nighttime, so it's dark. And all of a sudden, I heard the engine start going. No laughing matter. Now, well, I'm not the sharpest tool in the shed, but I knew something was going on. I looked up there in the first class section where musicians don't sit, and I saw that stewardess pick up the little phone, and she talked to the pilot. She hung it up. I'm telling you the truth. She hung up that little phone, sat down, turned white, and buckled herself in. Well, you know, I knew we definitely had a problem then. I pulled out my Bible. I love the Word of God. I pulled out my Bible, but I didn't know until that minute that I was a speed reader. Genesis to Revelation twice. 3 minutes. And by that time, the pilot came on and he said, y'all, I need to talk to you. We've got a serious. Well, he didn't say y'all. Ben said, y'all, I'd have figured he was a crop duster from Mississippi. I wouldn't have got on the plane in the first place. But anyway, he said something to the effect of, everybody, I need to talk to you. We're experiencing some engine trouble. We need to bring the plane down. But he said, to add to the problem, we've got to bring it through the wall of a storm. And he said, ladies and gentlemen, it's going to be a very, very, very rough ride. About that time, the stewardess from the back come running up, and they put that little recording back on again. In case the oxygen thing drops down or whatever, it may not totally inflate. Just breathe naturally. Breathe naturally? I figured if I strap that thing on there, when I take one pull, it's going to be like a Hoover vacuum cleaner plugged into 220. When I pull on that thing one time, the pilot's socks were coming off. You know what I mean? Ain't no breathing naturally. And she come walking by, and she said, everybody, buckle up. And she said, is there anything before I sit down? Does anybody need anything? I said, yes, ma'am. I said, I need something. She said, what? I said, is it true that that little black box is the only thing that survives a crash? She said, well, sir, we're not planning on crashing. I said, I didn't ask that. I asked, is it true that little black box, the only thing that survives? She said, well, yes, sir, it usually does survive a crash. I said, well, I don't know how little it is, but if I take my shoes off and you point me to it, I believe I could get inside of it right about now. I was feeling double jointed, if you know what I mean. And I was talking to the Lord, and I said, Lord, if I need forgiveness for anything at all, you just let me know. And so I got to thinking about telling that boy we could sing I'll Fly Away backwards. And I thought, now, if I need forgiveness, it was just a figure of speech. You know, but if I need forgiveness, Lord, forgive me. So if y'all would, y'all sing along with me, and I'll feel a whole lot better about it. Y'all just sing with me. Away, fly, glory, oh, away, fly. Y'all just sing with me. By and by, hallelujah, die when away, fly. Y'all not singing very much. Away, fly, glory, oh, away, fly. Come on now. By and by, hallelujah, die when away, fly. Y'all not helping me at all. I tell you what, why don't we try a verse to see if y'all know that? I doubt it. Or is life when morning gladsome away, fly. Sure, celestial God on home a two away, fly. Everybody now, away, fly, glory, away, fly. By and by, hallelujah, die when away, fly. We at least need a big ending on this thing. Now, y'all help me. By and by, hallelujah, die when it's just away, fly, away, fly. Give yourselves a hand.